not like they took a picture of a green plant as an apple. They get a picture of a pile of sugar.
It sounds like...
It's just shocking.
It sounds like, I've been reading Stephen Pinker's new book, The Stuff of Thought, and he talks about thought as metaphor. So we have it as a representation. And so like when we talk about relationships, it's like a journey. So you say we went our separate ways. You know, that there's a lot of that kind of language. And he also talks about for different domains, like for example, we talk about genetics as code. You know, as a metaphor, and it almost sounds like you're trying to get them to make their metaphor explicit, almost. But I found that an interesting concept that we think in metaphor, we talk in metaphor.
What is the product of photosynthesis?
I didn't know what they would do, but I know that they've never been asked to do this before.
Yeah.
And so that was the point, was to, I asked them, the most typical or traditional was the text, and concept to concept, they were a little uneasy with it. But then the image part, for many of them, was shocking. They would never ask them to represent the concept. And they felt very comfortable if they were allowed to choose an image. Not diagram, they wanted the diagram. They wanted to give me that picture of the water cycle, I know it.
How much time did they have?
Hour, a couple of hours, and they're given a camera, go, whatever it takes. So. But it was shocking for them at first to get this piece of data, what is it going to look like? Try to come up with a determinant methodology, I guess, for interpreting.
We've published a book called Multimodal Learning and Teaching, which is about it's a report from a project in science classrooms. 2001, and if you came across it, you'd see some accounts of interpretations, including the plant cells.
Friday of the holiday weekend.
Is it the holiday weekend?
It's Nevada Day for us.
Really?
Yeah.